What up? Happy Movie Monday. Wow, the music was really quiet. I probably just blew your eardrums out. I'm sorry. Oopsies. I know. Well, the music was down really low and I didn't realize it. And this is the volume that my mic usually is at, but you probably had it turned up because of the music. So, gotcha. Scared ya. Hello, chat. How are you? Oh my God, the Mac is back. The Mac is back for 3 months. At least one other streamer had to have made that joke. Like, that seems like such low-hanging fruit. Return of the Mac. Fuck! That's way funnier than what I said. Damn it. Okay. Thank you for the 3 months. I appreciate it. I'm assembling a blanket shelf. What does that mean? Is that a shelf for your blankets? Or are you making a fort? You know what would be fun? Maybe. I'm trying to think of a way to do it. If you just had a bunch of streamers making a fort in the living room. I don't really know if that would be fun to watch, though. Chat stays being funnier than Sam. Dude, I know. It's not, you know. Making a blanket fort is hard on the knees as an adult. It is, and then once I get in there, oh, thanks, dogs. Once I get in there, I am like, what do I do now? Like, I don't remember as a kid, once I made a fort, what I did in it. Like, I think I just would go sit in it and then enjoy the time, but I guess what I would probably do now is watch a movie. If I were to make a fort now, it would be my whole living room. I wouldn't be able to escape from the fort. I just sat in it. Yeah, you know, I miss the days of making a fort, going in it, and then just being perfectly satisfied with that. You know? Blast a fat pre-roll joint and watch Netflix in the fort. Yeah, there we go. Maybe I build a fort and then I stream from inside the fort. Yeah. So you mentioned about stream awards on Twitter and thought I'd check out your stream. Welcome. Welcome in. Yeah, we're going to be voting streamer awards. I have decided not to campaign this year, which sounds funny because it's an award show. Last year, like, everybody was campaigning for, not everybody. Seemed like the people that were going for, like, Rising Star and stuff were, like, campaigning. And I didn't really want to do it because something about it felt kind of weird, you know, just because it's an awards show. So I was like, I feel weird asking people for an award because if I get it, then it's like, did I really win this? Because I campaigned for it, I guess. But I was like, you know what? Fuck it. Like, that would be really fucking cool. And I wanted to go. So I did it. And I felt kind of weird doing it the whole time, but I just was like, fuck it. I'm in the industry. Like, you gotta be a little bit shameless sometimes. And a year later, I'm still like, I just felt kind of weird about doing it. So this year I've decided, like, I'm not gonna campaign. I would love to win an award. I would love if all of you voted. I'm going to ask you guys if you would consider. And that would be fucking cool. I'm not pretending like I'm any better than the awards show. I just don't want to campaign for it because it made me feel kind of weird. And also another thing is I don't want to feel any type of way when I don't get it. I want to feel perfectly impartial about anybody else that I know getting voted in and winning. You know what I mean? Like, there's a bunch of people that I know that are good friends of mine that, like, are wanting and campaigning. And I want to just kind of not feel anything if I don't get it. Does that make sense? Kind of. Because last year I, like, kind of campaigned for it and then I was like, dang it. And this time I just want to be like, all right, cool. I'm still going, you know? So anyways, if you're voting, I would love it if you voted for me. That'd be fucking cool. I would love to win. But I'm not going to make a video. I'm not going to post on Twitter. I'm not going to do any of that because I don't have it in me. I need you to be on that stage in the cunt dress. I know. Well, here's the thing is I don't have a cunty dress yet. So now I'm going to have to make sure that my dress is extra cunty. Is that the copy pasta from, how did you guys get that? Did you just memorize it from my DMs? I don't think I posted it anywhere. Did I? I'm going to go looking right now. I'm really excited. I'm going to try to do an IRL stream looking for a dress. I don't know if I'll get one because I don't know the logistics of it, but I would like to do that. Name your prize for best series. No, I love Name Your Price and I love the people that are in it, but Paranormal Detour is getting my vote for best series and it is no contest otherwise. No contest otherwise. There are a lot of wonderful productions on Twitch. There is nothing like Paranormal Detour. There is nothing even close. And so it would win across the board for me. You know, it is unique. It is entertaining. It is just like there is nothing like it. There's nothing like it. But there are a really good. What I'm going to encourage you guys to do as we vote is to shout out as many creators that you think should win, because I'm not going to vote and be like, everybody vote for what I'm voting for. I'm just going to like go through and give you guys the opportunity to bring up streamers or productions or things that maybe the rest of us haven't heard of because it's fun. Can you do Eggs Benny in Aussieland? I think so. I mean, at the very least, I can make it, you know? Are we still voting for LeBron James Sprite Cranberry game? You guys are so hung up on that game.
For the LeBron James Sprite Cranberry game.
It was like a 15-minute game that didn't even resonate with me. I hated it. And you guys just have attached onto it. We aren't supposed to hive mind our voting. I mean, we can. I don't care. Whatever. Cooking Eggs Benny stream would be slay. Yeah, it would be kind of fun. The thing is if I go over there and I do an IRL stream, I have to get service on my second phone. So, oh my gosh, 10 gifties from Cyril. This is unprecedented. Nobody could have known. Hold on. Is the music duck enough that you can't hear it over the top of this? For best head bob. There we go. Best juicer award, streamer awards winner, best juicer. You might be able to just rent a modem for 2 weeks. I can do, there's an app that Brody uses that he told me about that is what I'm gonna use for when I'm there to have service. So yeah, is the rare thank you sub still? Yes, it is Mortitome. Thank you Cyril, thank you so much, I appreciate that. Plushie, welcome in. He's got a streaming phone, just yoink his. That is true, actually. That is true that he does. He has like 16 cell phones. And it's not like most of them are like in a bucket and then one of them he uses. Like, he always will like send a picture of something and there's like multiple phones out on the counter. It's like, why are you using all of those every day? Sussy? I know, he's got a burner. I bet that's not even his real name. Why? Well, I do understand it because I have two phones and I will like use one of my phones while the other one's on the charger. I will like watch a show on one phone while using the other one. Like, having a spare phone is actually really nice. You don't realize that it's something that will be helpful, and then you get one and you're like, dang, that's actually really nice to have one. I don't know what you would do with three of them, let alone like four, but I have the spare phone for streaming and it's really helpful sometimes, especially when you think Y2K2 is happening. So you have to check if the internet's down on your second phone. Every time you drink Red Bull from that glass, I think it's straight whiskey. It looks like that or like piss. Like this is, if you're not drinking enough water, this is pretty uncanny. Do you have two phone plans? Yeah, I have one of like the main providers on my main phone. That I can't say because, can I say this? I may or may not be sponsored in the near future by a major phone plan, so I'm trying to avoid saying what phone carrier I have. But on my second phone, on my stream phone, I use Mint Mobile. It's really cheap. It doesn't say anything. Yeah. Blake, thank you for the 100 bits. Is it two cans connected by a string? That would be a fun stream idea. You could use like two lav mics and see how far away you could actually hear. Mint Invisible or Goated. Mint is really good and like it's really cheap, and I'm trying to figure out why people don't have it. Is there a reason why people don't have it? Because it's like $30 a month for unlimited data. And the service is perfect. Having a second phone on Mint is a good idea. Why don't people have it? Is it just because it's not a well-known plan? Mint didn't have good speeds in my area? Okay. Mint customer service is bad? Okay. These are all valid reasons. I tried it for a while? Okay. I used to work for Sprint, they then worked for a contractor. I still get stupid cheap price. That's really nice. Heard low speeds. That's what I use for my IRL streaming phone. So it has to be pretty fast. No physical locations, lower priority during surges. Okay. Maybe not wide coverage. Yeah, I am living in LA, like everything's going to be covered. I did go to my parents' house in Oregon and they live in like a very small town. And my main phone didn't get any service at their house, but my spare phone did. Ryan Reynolds, yeah, I use Mint, but I was a little bummed when I found out it's only $15 a month if you buy multiple months at a time. Oh. I wonder which company is sponsoring Sam. You actually probably couldn't guess, and I probably shouldn't talk about Mint Mobile so much. It's not Mint Mobile. It's not. I vouch for Mint Mobile, but it's not that. Mint is like $400 a year. Yeah, for unlimited data, I spend about $30 a month. They have sales all the time. But I don't know. I guess like there's probably a lot of downsides, but if you're somebody that like is kind of strapped for cash and you want a cheap phone plan, like that one's pretty good. Is it the People's Republic of China? I don't know what that means.
I voted for you as best Minecraft streamer. Just a cute little joke of mine. I think QT will find it hilarious.
Max with the longest sub alert. I think the only person that has a custom sub alert on the whole channel. Thank you for the 7 months. Max, I don't know why this happened, but somebody got Brody to watch that on his stream the other day. And then he was like, I'm going to make that Sam's custom sub alert. And I was like, I thought the US was a duopoly between Verizon version and AT-8. Cooser, this is the most drunk message. I thought the US was a duopoly between version and AT&T. Bobby has seen it as well. I'm so honored. It's big. It is big. If it hits 2K views, I just want to take responsibility. Version and attitude. I knew what they meant, so it's all good. I don't know. I mean, it seems like it. It's in the US we have Verizon, AT&T, Sprint and T-Mobile. And then there's other ones, but it seems like the other ones are kind of under the umbrella of those four. And I don't even know that some of those aren't the same company. But yeah, T-Mobile took over Sprint. Really? Yeah. Isn't that so funny when big companies pretend that they're multiple smaller companies so that you'll just, they can raise their own prices? Like, it's so funny. It's like, okay, I sell apples and I can't, and I sell them to people. And then I create another company that's called Apples and Apples. And then people are trying to decide whether they like apples or apples and apples. And then there's a battle between these two companies, but I'm both companies, so I just win. T-Mobile also bought Mint. Yeah, I did know that. And Ryan Reynolds. Actually love that. It's my favorite thing. It's big. Ren really loves corporate companies, so she talks about it a lot. So if you're big into corporate companies, boy, do I have the streamer for you. Start a company called Oranges. Yeah, that probably would have been actually like a better thing. Can we have a vote on our favorite megacorps? Yeah, I'm hoping that's in the streamer awards. So what if I vote for you for every category on the streamer awards page? You can. I don't care. I mean, I'll go through and tell you guys who I'm voting for, but whatever. Ooh, my first harassment message of the day. This is big. This is big for us. US is just five companies each wearing trench coats. That is literally it. That's literally it. That's honestly, Koozer, that's not a terrible content idea. I ranked all of the evil companies in the world. Is there a tier maker list of that? Evil companies. Evil corporations tier list. Okay, well, this one has none in it. I don't know these companies. This is a pretty good one. I'm not going to do it, I don't think. But, like, PayPal. I don't know what this one is. Don't know that one. Amazon. Mac. I love doing tier maker lists. I wish it was easier to make them. It's a little bit of a pain in the ass to make tier maker lists on stream. Because you have to, like, take pictures. You have to have them be, like, the same shape and, like, upload them. And it's, I don't know. I don't like doing it. It'd be nice if you could do it on the fly. Like, if you could just have a tier maker list and then add to it. Because you can't add to other people's tier maker lists very well. Are we still boycotting Disney because of Sandwich? Yes, that and no other reason. What if we paid Caitlyn? Listen. There's just that one. There was a bunch of companies that I didn't know. Just use the same black squares for all of them and just like verbally say what it is. I really wish they'd let you add pictures to tier lists. It's, I just wish there was like a easier way to like make it on the go. Like if I could just like drag and drop photos onto the tier maker website, that'd be great. What if I do it for free? Yeah, can you throw some things in there that are like, can you just put Scootish on it too? Can every tier maker list you make, can you put Scootish on it? What did you guys do today? I woke up late once again, but I think that's okay because my sleep schedule will be fine. And then what did I do? I did laundry today. I'm still doing laundry technically. And I just kind of like cleaned a little bit. I'm just kind of like preparing my house, I guess, you know? Because tomorrow night I pack and then later on in the week I go. So, you know, I did nothing, but I can say it so many more words. Nice. Can't you stream Saltburn on here? No, it's DMCA. I mean, I could do it with like a Amazon watch party, but I don't know if I actually can. I do Saltburn on an Amazon watch party. That's not TOS, is it? Hello, Evils. Can I? I want to show this clip of Evils that she put in the Discord. I know a lot of you are having a hard time with the Minecraft server, but this is a really wholesome and sad clip, but I laughed out loud when I watched this.
As many as you want. The only thing is, like, the computer has to be on.
Oh, there's a chicken here.
Where are you? What chicken?
It's a chicken! And Meatloaf Cube doesn't even know about this chicken.
That's the part that killed me. Meatloaf Cube doesn't even know about this chicken. It was so wholesome, but I was crying laughing. It was so funny. just slowly, like, disintegrating into shambles. Just so anyways, the Minecraft SMP players are doing well. They're doing good. I don't have enough money for chicken nuggets. That's what broke me. The sad music in the background, too. You weren't doing yourself any favors. Suffering. Can we get another Twitch name drawing stream again one day? Yeah, we can. I actually, like, So, kind of recently, I wanted to do the drawing Pokemon from memory stream with, like, other, I wanted to do it where I have a section of the Discord and then you guys can do it along with me. But the art category was so fucked that I didn't do it. And then same with the drawing usernames thing. Like, I was just like, you know what? We're going to hold off on that one for a while, because as much as I don't really care, I just couldn't handle the kind of chatters that I knew I was going to get. So that has been my mental state for the last few days. Have any of you guys loaded up the save and just, like, walked around solo? The drawing username stream was a surprising gem. Like, I didn't really expect you guys to like it so much. Also, if you can't read the title, we're watching Saltburn in the Discord at, like, 10 o'clock-ish. I know it's a little bit later, but I'm up late, and I'm going to be up late, and so I want to watch it, and I don't want to do a quick stream. So we're going to be doing it at, like, 10:30. So if you don't want to watch Saltburn, probably don't come to movie night tonight. I don't know anything about it. Nothing. I don't have any spoilers. I've heard two things. I've heard that there is a guy in it whose dick looks like a banana. And then I've also heard that it's kind of, I'm 14 and I'm deep, like, trying to talk about eat the rich people, but not getting into the depth of it, you know. I also have heard no spoilers. No, I know it's shocking, but I don't know why. We'll probably have to just kind of, like, glance, trigger warning kind of stuff, but I know that it's, like, nudity, sex scenes. I don't know what else. I don't know what else. Have you seen the killing of a sacred deer? No. I literally know nothing about it. I don't either. I don't know. I know that Jacob Elordi's in it, so that's a plus. But that's it. I actually haven't seen Cocaine Bear, which is funny because that was my Halloween costume. Yeah. Brody's in it. I've been roasted on both ends for making that connection. So I've started, I think I just have, I can't, I don't know. You know and listen to Hot Mulligan. I have a playlist made off of modern baseball. So yeah. It is a polarizing topic, as he should be. You are literally Cocaine Bear. That's true. Probably because of the mountains of cocaine that I like to snort. It asked for an international streamer, so I put sandwich in Australia. Do you think that'll count? True. I mean,
spaghetti,
that's true.
Is barking in his sleep right now. I thought you'd want to know.
I did want to know. Thank you, Morgan. I appreciate it. Thank you for the almost 2 years. This playlist is so good. Yeah. I mean, you know, it's just I went off of modern or Your Graduation by Modern Baseball, which is a song I like, and made a whole one. I love the fact that the Cocaine Bear thing happened in my state of is that Georgia? Although the bear just died in real life. I didn't realize it was a real story. I thought it was because the nickname you got when railing lines to the Brother Bear soundtrack. Oh, that's true. I forgot about that. Hello, Bihar. But yeah, I don't really have a whole lot to, I don't have any stories or anything. Like, I got nothing going on. I sent my landlord a meme today. I posted this in the Discord. He's making copies of my keys so that way when I'm gone, in case of like an emergency, my house isn't just locked up. And so he texted me and said, like, can I grab that house key? And I sent him this. I said, I have a proposal. And then he didn't reply for a really long time, so I thought maybe I just got too weird. But eventually he said, R-O-F-L. Which, you know, I think we're in the clear there. Mm-hmm. I'll watch your place for you. There's nothing to watch. Unless you want to stare at a wall. Not a whole lot. You know, just leave your keys in an unlocked car at the airport parking lot. Like, I think that he just does it because he knows that, like, I specifically will just be really flustered by the idea that that is a thing. Can everybody confirm that I'm not insane? What is backseating? It's like when I'm playing a game and you tell me how to play the game. And so usually when I play games, I say, no backseating. You can backseat, but please don't backseat.
Isro Fulbuma.
It kind of is, Flannel. It kind of is. Thank you for the 6 months. I appreciate it. This is what Brody does. When he flies, he drives his car to the airport, and then he leaves, and he's told his chat this, so I'm not, like, saying anything that, you know. He puts his keys in the back of his car and then just leaves the car unlocked so he doesn't have to take his keys with him because he doesn't want to lose his keys in another country. He just wants his keys to stay in his car. He told chat this. Not only did he tell his chat this, but he posted a picture of his car in Discord and said, guys, my car is still there. Like, is he okay? That's the problem, is if he was an idiot about everything, I would be like, let's be honest. If it was me, you guys would be like, okay, that makes sense. Stupid, but that makes sense for her. He doesn't do stupid things, so it's a calculated dumb thing, which is worse. It's like a calculated thing. Like, I know this is a bad idea, I'm gonna do it. But, yeah, like Rin said, is everybody that's saying it's really dumb is probably an American. The people that are saying it's kind of dumb probably live in countries where crime is just not as bad. I live in Los Angeles. I have like 16 different ways to lock my car up when it's in front of my house. Like, that shit is locked up. Granted, it's been stolen before, but my car is locked up and I have like three different, if you want to drive my car, there's like three different keys that you need. And I'm not kidding. I'm dead serious. Like, it is like a whole puzzle to get my car to drive. Until someone breaks the window to steal shit. I mean, I don't know what they're going to steal. Like, two different Starbucks cups that have been in there for a week. Have fun. You're doing me a favor. Nobody's going to pay $20. Well, that's his reasoning, is he's like, if you steal my car, you have to pay to get it out of the parking lot. So, and I was like, okay, well, I guess. Which is stupid, but also at the same time, like, the way that criminals work is legitimately they wouldn't go through the effort because of the $20. It's unhinged. Is the three key puzzle an effect of the theft? Yes. Yep. $20 for a shit car. Yeah. I mean, you've seen how he backs up trailers. That car's a ticking time bomb. Please don't tell me he also has other keys like his house keys. Oh, surely. Mind if I have a good night? Yeah, Matt. Does anybody mind if Matt has a good night? Thanks for checking. You always come in and check, and we appreciate that. Bitch got a deep-ass voice.
Yeah, and it can go deeper, and it's still sexy. So shut the fuck up.
It's called raspy, and it's very in right now. So I say the deeper the voice, the hotter. And you didn't even spell bitch right. I used to actually get kind of self-conscious about my voice, but I think the older I get, the more I kind of like it. You know what I mean? If you hate Sam's voice, you'd loathe mine. Rin's got a great voice. She's got like a radio voice. So it's just getting better. I hate mine, but I think most people hate the sound of their own voice. Being a streamer has definitely made me care about hearing my voice less. And also when you stream, what are you saying, I'm ugly? Shut the fuck up. As I stream more, you kind of exercise your, like, it's funny, if you listen, this is for, I'd say, all streamers. If you watch their first clips and then their most recent stream clips, like, I think you just work your vocal cords, and like, my voice is much stronger. It is deeper. When I first started streaming, my voice was a lot higher. But my voice has gotten like stronger, and I like it more now because it sounds like a voice that does a job where you talk a lot, where it didn't used to sound like that. Some people naturally have that, though. Some people naturally have really good speaking voices sound wise. You know, I'm trying to think of like Savior, Mr. Savior HD. He's got a very wonderful, yeah, Ted's a good example. Trying to think of other people that do. I think Longy does, kind of. You engage your diaphragm too, for sure, 100%. You learn to speak in a way that saves your voice. Yeah, when I first started streaming, I would get done with streaming and like my whole throat would like just be sore. Yeah, Pirate Software's voice. That's a person that I have heard their name a lot recently. Who are they? What do they do? I'm so jealous of people that have naturally cool voices. Who has the coolest voices that you know of? Like, which streamers do you think have really great voices? I'm a sucker for a good voice. I mean, it's a benefit, especially in this industry, you know? If it sounds good, then great. That man's voice has remained the same the whole time, true. No.
You.
Not the father. Congratulations. Hippo, thank you for the 9. Thank you for willingly giving me the child support, even though it is not for the sub. Logan, Sea Dog. I was going to say the VA and Sea Dog is for voice acting. Would you do a stream matching voice to Chatters? Oh, that's good, Jules. That's a good one. Having people read lines and then matching it to their faces. That's a really good one that I would be really afraid to do, though, because I would not want to, like, I would not want to fuck it up and, like, hurt somebody's feelings. That would be really good, though. No VOD? Why? Make the lines selected chat messages of theirs. Everyone submitting would just have to be accepting that it might happen. That's true. Hide your shame. My shame? Yeah, it would be... I would have to say, like, okay, anything could happen. I'm very sorry if I guess and it hurts your feelings. Just don't, you know what I mean? That's why you'd stream that on Lord Barney. No VOD, no shame. Nah, full shame. I mean, if I do it on main, I'd have to, it'd be the same as the bathroom stream where it's like, hey, if you are uncomfortable with me making comments about your physical appearance, just maybe sit out for this one. Or same thing, like if you are in a situation where like maybe guessing would make you uncomfortable, you know, we'll come up with other ones that'll be fun. Match the sneeze to the chatter. That's funny. No one will ever recognize my voice. You know, I was going to say maybe, but I think I would. Especially if it was like, you know, 3 and 3 and then your face was on there. If I had like a bunch of different voices and it was like, guess which one is B, I might struggle a little bit. From the OD trailer. Do my first ever Twitch voice reveal for the stream. That would be fun, Jules. That's a really great idea, actually. That's a really, really great idea. I like that a lot. I'll probably do that. I do want to do another exposed game, but I think I'll save it until the chatter awards, because that's just like another fun thing to tack onto it. And if you've never played the exposed game, we haven't played it for a couple months. What I do is I go through the exposed section and I grab a bunch of chat messages and then I make a slideshow and I have you guess who you think the messages are to. And I think I made a form. I at least talked about it, but I think I made a form that was like a consent form because I didn't want to grab any like for example, if I grabbed a message that Sylvan or Mason has put in chat, and then I say, okay, which one of these four people do you think wrote this? And I put somebody on there that is like not comfortable with me insinuating that they wrote a Mason or Sylvan type message. I don't want to make anybody uncomfortable. So last time I was like, I'm going to make a consent form that's just like, I consent to you insinuating that I have said the most fucked up shit. Sign. Yeah, I reveal it afterwards. Yeah. You've had people react to a Discord message with an emote and they gave permission. Oh, I did that?
When did I do that? Did I do Rules of the Den? Where did I put it?
Was it in notice board? I must have put it in notice board. Maybe I should put it in Rules of the Den, because then it won't move. Said some real fucked up shit. You know what's funny is I absolutely am going to put meatloaf cubes on there, because that could be anybody. It could be literally anybody, because you guys all say it too. Not everyone wants to be attached with Imagine how much dick you could suck with three heads. Right. I think most of you are cool with it. Also, another thing on top of that is when I go through and I do the exposed game, I go through and I watch old VODs and I just see names and I go, okay, that person. Okay, that person. And I just want everybody, like, if you're like, I really want to be in this game, then I can be like, oh cool, here's a whole list of people that want to be in the game, so I can switch it up, you know. So yeah, I don't think it's an exposed, might be. So anyways, we'll do that next month for the chatter awards. We'll do the chatter awards and then we'll do exposed and it'll be a great day, and maybe I'll wear a dress. I put in a word for Snooki. Thank you, I appreciate it. I went into Krub's stream and I was like talking shit, and then I said it would be funny because I was like, we were talking about the, like, I'm not campaigning for any award this year. And I was saying, alternatively, it would be really funny for me to find the worst possible people and get cameos from them to vouch for me for an award for streamer awards. I saw that tweet today. What tweet? Oh, the one for me saying I'm not campaigning. Are you still doing the survival stream? What survival stream? Oh, of Minecraft? Yeah, it's just been backlogged because there's other stuff. Biggest hate watcher? True. I'm going to add more categories too, and what I'll probably do is I'll put out a form for you guys, like the same way that Cutie does it, and be like, hey, what are some categories? Because last year, here, let me pull up the slideshow from last year, because this will be new. Get Congressman Santos to do the cameo. That's what Krub said. Chatter awards. So this is from last year. So we had most wholesome, which is my mom. Most cursed. So what we do is I do it the same way Cutie does the streamer awards. I do a Google form. You guys get to write in who you think out of everybody. I whittle it down to four people, and then you guys get to vote again, and then you win. Most cursed was Sylvan. Horniest chatter was Shay. Discord MVP, Jake. Keck W Award, Mike. Sorry, it's flashbanging you in between each of these, by the way. Most likely to be Mark Dudlick was John Boris. Twitch Frog was Non. So I put a picture of his parents. Resident Artist, Artsy. Most likely to be a normie, Cheese. Most likely to be banned, John. With his straight hair before I told him he needed to shampoo it. Most likely to be a bot, me. Word Count Award, Apex. With an animation for some reason. Hate Watcher Award, Soup. Best Clip, Joni. Best Lurker, T-Pain. Fuck. Emote Machine was Gibby. Best Mod Award was all of the mods. Best Stream Memory was Hired or Fired. Game of the Year, Poop Killer. Streamer Cameo Award. Okay, so this is person that comes on my stream often, that, and you guys picked Barry. And then Chatter of the Year was Caitlin11. And I think that was it. So we're going to do more categories this year. Because that was the first year we ever did it. I think this year I'm not going to allow repeats. I think. What do you guys think? Should we allow? Can we do gayest? Yeah, sure. I mean, right? That's fine, I guess. I don't really, it's, you know what I mean? We also did that last year. You didn't let us win multiple awards. Yeah, I think I'm definitely going to do that. So people can't win. I don't want any sweeps. And also, I want to make it so that you can't win the same award you won last time. You can win another award, but you can't win the same award. Because I think there's a couple that would repeat, which is fun. I don't know. What do you guys think? Here, let me do this real quick. Do you guys think that you should be able to win an award multiple years in a row? Do the poll. It's only 60 seconds. Are we? Because if you think that they should, that's fine. It would be kind of fun to have the two times, but I don't know. I don't really care either way. It could be fun. So the poll is gone in 60 seconds. Yes. If they earn it, yeah. Only Soup can win Hate Watcher. Well, that's what I'm saying, is like ones like that would be really funny if Soup gets it every year. So I don't know. There's some awards would be funny for there to be a repeat, and then others where I don't think it would add anything. Yeah. I don't want the whole awards show to be repeats, but I don't think it will. I think some will, but I don't think it will. If Mike is the funniest for multiple years, he should get it. Yeah. Yeah. Repeat. Okay. Okay. Cool. That's fine then. We'll do that. If someone can go back to back on an award, then good on him. Okay, yeah. There are tons of new names, so I don't think it'll be a problem. That is true. Is between last year and this year, there has been like a, I don't want to say a turnover, but there's been like a pretty massive new influx of people. Like I would say like 50% of the chat is like new and different. So yeah, that's true. Okay, cool. Who are you? Do you guys want to vote for streamer award stuff? Might as well, right? Mason wasn't in the last one. He'll be nominated for horniest. True. I'm new and different. True. Are you planning, Tara? Are you in planning mode? Wedding planning shenanigans? Or are you like taking a bit? Will there be new awards? Yeah, I'm going to actually put out a Google form probably when I get home that will be like asking you guys what awards you think would be good. Because I think we could have twice as many, to be honest. I'll technically be new and different after surgery. That's so exciting. Are you so happy? Can I tell chat, or are you kind of like trying to just like keep on the DL? Because I know you've been trying to, you can talk about it. Yeah, Chloe's getting, it's bottom surgery, right? Which is, I know you've been like trying to do that for like a hot second. And it's coming up fast. Soon. In February. That's so fucking cool. I have no clue what I'd even be a good nominee for. There's like gonna be, I think people will get really creative with the categories. It's been surreal how soon it's coming now. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, February is really soon. It'll be here before you know it. And then you'll have an excuse to just have a lot of lazy days. Which, surgery's not always super fun, but then you can be like, you know what? Fuck it. I want to lay in bed all day and I want to watch this TV show. And I'm gonna fucking do it. I have a category idea already. I would make the Google form now, but I think it would get lost in the sauce, so I probably won't make it yet. I've been joking it's the ultimate form of self-love since I'll be sent home on Valentine's Day. Perfect. True. Did I miss Sam vote for Sin for Rising Star? You didn't, know. I'll be bedridden for 4 to 6 weeks. Oh, really? I mean, I guess, yeah. You gotta get some games. Can you, like, you'll be able to game for a bit. Probably not the first, like, couple days and stuff, but eventually, like, you'll be able to just, you have to get some, like, what are some games that she can play to just, like, sink her teeth in? Like, what are some, like, I'm trying to think of games that are just, like, degen you can spend a bunch of fucking hours in. Yeah, Stardew. Stocked up on Switch games and Kindle reading, yeah. Yeah, true Minecraft. Slime Rancher's a good one. House Flipper's a good one. Power Wash Sim. Put a good show on and watch Power Wash Sim. I played Power Wash Sim for like 5 hours last night. I was watching the rest of the Gypsy Rose doc, which ended with a huge cliffhanger, and I don't know, it says to be continued, and I was like, where? When? You guys said it was a 6-part thing, and it was 6 parts. Power Wash and like Percy Jackson sounds like a great day. That's what I've been doing, is like putting a show on and playing Power Wash Sim, and it has like put my brain in like a really great spot. She's just living her life now. How is there a cliffhanger? Well, I don't want to spoil it, but like the last episode is like the day that she gets out of prison, and then there's a thing that happens that kind of is a little bit of a issue, but then it cuts and they say to be continued. And then you're like, where? Here? Or when? Like, it already happened. Like, it's been resolved. So, I don't know. It was really weird. I want to be spoiled so bad. I mean, I can spoil it. I can just tell everybody and then they can not. Okay, I'm going to spoil the ending of the doc. And I'm going to hold my hand up when it's done being spoiled. And I know that the captions are on screen. Actually, I'm going to type in chat when I'm done spoiling it. It's the end of the Gypsy Rose Lifetime doc, okay? So mute the stream if you don't want to hear this. So she gets out of prison on the last day of the doc. And she goes home to her family to spend a couple days with them before she goes back to Louisiana to be with her husband. She got married in prison. And while she's in, I think it's Missouri. While she's in Missouri with her family, visiting them right after prison, they call her and they're like, you need to leave the state. They were like, you told us that you were going to go home to Louisiana and you're not allowed to like go to your parents' house for a couple days and hang out. You need to leave the state right now. And so it's really stressful because her parole officer is like talking to the whoever they are, and she's crying because she's like, I don't want them to send me back. I don't want them to send me back. Because, like, you know, the first day she gets out of prison, she already broke one of the rules without realizing it. And so it's like a big panic because they're not sure. They're like, okay, well, I guess do I have to leave right now? Do I get to stay the night here? Like, am I in trouble? Did I ruin anything? And then it says to be continued. So, and it's a 6-part documentary, and that's on the 6th episode. So, like, I don't know. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know where they're going to put it. I don't know when they're going to put it. I don't know, whatever. So anyways, okay. Okay. Spoilers are over. Okay. I'm not going to talk about it anymore. Yeah. Anyways, it's a little funky. It's a little confusing, but you know, we've been watching her on TikTok. So, I made this TikTok today. Speaking of TikToks, this is why I was late for stream, because I was making this video.
So you're gonna take a left.
Okay.
Oh no, that's... No, my God. You just f***ing killed somebody. We have to get out of here.
I probably technically shouldn't show this on stream, but oopsies.
I'm going! Oh no, are those there?
This could be anybody.
I don't know where we're going either, and my glasses are fogged up.
Oh my God, Ruth, they're still on us.
You have a knife on you?
Jesus Christ.
Okay, it's fine. I'm very fast. Okay, they're cut.
So you're gonna take
God, that was such a funny moment. It was so good. Okay, let me find, probably on Cutie's Twitter. Could have been anybody's voice. Could have been anybody. Can you imagine if I got banned because I showed like a 30-second clip? That'd be, actually would not be surprising. Okay, let me sign in here. I didn't know you were the old lady. I've seen you so many people's streams. That's me. There's so many times that, like, I've watched other people's streams and they've ran into me and their chat has been like, who is that? And somebody will say sandwich. And then they'll be like, huh? Because I guess it doesn't sound like me. Okay. First off, I'm going to post this link here because if you would like to vote along, you're more than welcome to. I know a lot of you guys only watch me and like two other people and that's it. And so you're not going to know who to vote for any of these. So if you want any ideas, there you go. I'm not going to persuade you to vote for anybody, but I know sometimes coming up with ideas is hard. And, you know, if you have a second monitor and you want to do that. Also, you're now 72 years old. Well, allegedly. Okay. Best creative art streamer. The best streamer to watch for art, music, food, drink, and or makers and crafting content. Best creative art streamer. Okay. We could do Oh, Ross is a great one. Cheese is a good one. Scum Art is a good one. This is true. Did Cheese stream 200 hours? Probably. I don't think 200 hours is too incredibly difficult, but Meat Canyon is a good one. Birdie's Daily Dicks. Who's Jubs? Mark Dudlick, I think, is who I voted for last year. No, actually, maybe it was Danny, but I don't think Danny really streams a whole lot anymore. Cutie and her cakes. I feel like you can vote for Cutie for any of these, but I bet she takes herself out of the running. So it's like, it's a nice gesture, but I'm pretty sure she doesn't allow herself to win. So, you know. Because I bet she would have won multiple categories at this point. Yeah. Voted for Salami Meats? Who's that? I'm mad because Master Baker can't get nominated. Yeah, that is true. That is true. Or no, who was it? I think I voted for Danny.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah, Liz is great.
Liz is fantastic. You know who's also a really great food and drink streamer is Nurse Huckleberry. Nurse Huckleberry is like a real good one. Wasn't Shitcam a nominee for the first year? Yeah, but I think maybe that's just so many other people, you know? Would Sandy qualify for this? I don't know. This dude art is crazy. Oh, I think I follow him, actually. Yeah. Since he does so many cooking streams, I guess. There's a lot of people that does. You know what I mean? Mod doesn't make the cut for you? What do you mean? My music vote is Jesu. I don't know who that is. No, I have an idea, like, Sandy, there's a couple people, that, are a hidden gem for me, and Sandy kind of is in that realm. Not even an honorary vote. Okay. It's snowing outside. Oh, cute. Best MMO streamer. I cannot think of a single one. I cannot think of a single MMO streamer that I know. Yeah, S-Fan's a good one. See, here's the thing. When it comes to an MMO streamer, I'm probably not going to vote on them because of the fact that they do MMO, because I don't watch MMO streams, but it would be, okay, I like this streamer. They also, like, S-Fan. I think S-Fan's fantastic. I have not watched any of his MMO stuff. MMO is, like, World of Warcraft, ESO, RuneScape, like those big multiplayer games. I'll probably put S-Fand just because of all the people that stream MMOs. He's the only one that I really watch enough to be like, yeah, I think he's great. I could also skip it, but nah. Yeah. Best strategy game streamer. Streamer that creates the best content while playing strategy games like this is another one where I've never watched any of this shit. But there's streamers that I like that have done this stuff. Non may be the only person because he streams Dota. I don't think I can say another person that I know of that streams these other games. I just voted for a Yu-Gi-Oh guy I watch. I don't know any of those people. I'm putting Non. My Dota streamer. Best chess streamer. Best streamer to watch for chess content. I want to check because I know in past years she's called it the Streamer Awards because it can encapsulate YouTubers as long as they're not banned. Yeah, so last year I think she clarified that it could be any platform as long as they're not banned, any streaming platform. Yeah, okay. Cuz I was going to say I know that Ludwig streams chess, and since I was supposed to be in chess boxing, maybe that's where I would lean, but I don't know. Botez. Oh, true. They'll win. Unless maybe... Wait, didn't the... It was like the Gotham something guy win last year? Yeah, I do think of Botez. I've never watched them play chess, though. Anna Kramling. That's true. I've actually clicked on her streams a lot recently. Not to watch, but just to click on it. It's a bit wild to me that the chess category has hung around all 3 years. Yeah, it seems to be just kind of the fallback, too. There's a lot of fallback things that streamers can do, like Super Mario 64, I think, is one of them, where it's like they'll always be around because it's an easy thing for streamers to kind of go back to when there's not a whole lot of games going on. So, like, chess is, you know, yeah, chess is there. I don't know. I'm going to put Ludwig. I don't... This is such a unsubstantial vote because I don't really watch chess streamers, but I'm still going to put it there. Best software and stream dev. Game dev streamer. I don't know if I can think of a single person for this. I am glad that she added this, though, because I know that this is one that a lot of people were asking for. Doug. True! Yeah. True. Best fighting game streamer. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Super Smash Bros. Is in here. I don't know anybody that streams Smash regularly. Josh Man streams Smash. Mango, yeah, I've never watched Slime. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, like Slime or like Josh Man or that's about it. I just voted Slime. Yeah. Sure, why not? Bald representation. Best speedrun streamer. Okay, this is one of the first ones that I'm gonna have a couple people that will fit into there. Eric won this last year. I don't know if he can win it again. Squeaks probably will have a good shot, to be honest with you. Yeah, Bobby's a good one. Linkus is a good one. I have not watched a whole lot of Linkus. Simply, I haven't watched a whole lot of Simply. Haven't watched a whole lot of Distortion. I put Squeaks for my favorite VTuber. Yeah. I think I'm going to put Bobby. Just for the principle of it. I did Parky. Yeah, Parky's a good one. Hidden Gem. So this is one that I've had a couple ideas, and I hate voting for this one because there's too many people. But there's a couple that stand out. Two of them, three, let's see, there's, okay, I hate it because I never want to not say somebody that's obvious. There's three people that I would be amiss if I didn't mention. Alice, for one. That Sandwich Dude, another one. And then Scootish is a big one for me. I don't think Parky can be in this one because I think Parky averages over 100 viewers. Yeah, Barry. I would, but it's the 200 hours one, which I could throw Barry in for the principle of like, fuck it, I know he hasn't streamed 200 hours, but you know. I voted for Alice, but who is surprised? Yeah. I also have Barry in mind for another one even though that one's not really as relevant as it used to be, but this is tough where there's so many great people. I think last year I like considered leaving this empty. Scootish is that small? I mean, that's a good question, actually. Is Scootish under 100? Actually, that might not. Just Googled Hidden Gem Award. Yeah! 92.3. Let's go. Okay. So there's a lot of people that I could put in this, and there's a lot of people that deserve it. I think that Scootish is by and far like one of the funniest people that I know. Not only is he hysterical, but he is very creative, and he's also a wonderful person behind the scenes. He's more than happy. There's been so many times that I have asked him on a whim to be a part of content, and he is always down. And he says some shit that just fucking makes me howl. And he is an entertainer. He is an entertainer. There are a lot of people I would love to put into this, but for the principle of what it is, he is an entertainer. I think Barry actually qualifies. He has 215 hours in 2023, according to Twitch Tracker. I was going to put Barry in for VTuber. But Scootish is fucking hilarious, yeah. He's also got at clutch shots. True. True. The fact I thought he was bigger is why I'm giving it to him. Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, there are a lot of good people. Barry, unmatched. Does shit unlike pretty much anybody I know. I was gonna put Barry in for League of Their Own, which I think is just like there's nobody that fits it better. But there are like so many people that would be great for this. But Scootish has 110 average viewers for the year. That is not what Twitch Tracker says. So I'm just going off of Twitch Tracker. I also just want to say, I don't think I need to say this, but I'm feeling like maybe I'm going to need to say this. I don't want to argue with anybody about who I pick. And if anybody gets burnt or rubbed the wrong way because I didn't pick your streamer, you can also vote for them. So I kind of feel that bubbling in the water here. Like, just kind of saying that. Like, you can tell me who you think should win. That's great. Because I put Scootish in here does not mean that I mean that anybody else on the platform is less deserving. That's who I'm putting here. Perfect. Best Battle Royale streamer. Best streamer. Fortnite, Apex, PUBG, Call of Duty, Warzone. I don't know any Warzone people. I don't know any PUBG people anymore. Apex? There's a couple people I know that stream Apex. Fortnite? There's a good amount of people that stream Fortnite. How dare you pick someone I don't watch? I just, every time I do this, I feel bad because I don't want somebody to think that, like, I don't want somebody to, it's going to happen. Somebody's going to come in here. They're going to be lurking. They're going to see I didn't vote for them. They're going to get their feelings hurt. I can't avoid it. If I wanted to avoid it, I just wouldn't do this live, which maybe I shouldn't anymore. But, you know, this category is dominated of 5 to 6 people. Yeah. Yeah, Chris is a good one. Chris is a good one. Yeah, Chris is a good one. I'm trying to think of other people that I watch. I always go off of like, who do I watch, you know? Who do I watch? Do Fortnite. I guess maybe Chris the most. Yeah. Always ends up doing great Fortnite runs. I have never streamed or never planned Fortnite. I believe I fit this category perfectly. Watch Sammy the most. Yeah, Sammy's a really great one. I'm gonna vote Sammy. We always need more girls in all categories. Best FPS streamer. Okay, same but different. This is really gonna be hard because actually Fortnite's not an FPS streamer, isn't it? Is Fortnite an FPS game? Because it's third person. No. Yeah. Plus it's got fucking Legos. It's got all this other shit. Overwatch, Call of Duty, Valorant, Halo. Overwatch, I can vote Lulu. Does Lulu do Overwatch? I thought she did like Apex mostly. Slime streams Valorant. True. Nothing but respect for my Valorant streamer. What does CSGO stand for? Mm-hmm. Rising Star Award. I don't want to write myself in because I just simply don't want to be that guy. I would love to win this. I'm not campaigning this year because I did it last year and something in my being felt not good about it. I did it because like I saw a lot of other people campaigning. I think that you totally should campaign if you want to. I just, the whole time I did, I was like, I'm a little out of my comfort zone. But I would love to win this. That does not diminish the fact that I would be over the moon and I do qualify. I just don't want to write myself down because I don't. Just can't do it. My campaign is how I fan your stream. Let's go. Even getting nominated would be huge. I don't actually care if I win, if I got nominated. I think that that would be good enough. I don't know. It's an honor to be considered. The thing about this one and the Hidden Gem one are a little bit funny because they're kind of like vouchers are a really big thing for that. So like, I don't think I have an audience like big enough to really have like a hard pull for this. So I'm not campaigning because I don't want to get hopeful. I don't want to like put my brain in any like mindset. I'm just kind of like, I'm just happy to go. I'm just happy to be there. Great. Whatever. So I'll put me in, but I don't, you know. Best roleplay streamer. Streamer with the best RP content. I think I have to pick Squeaks here. S-Fan's been really good. Squeaks has been really fucking good. Will has been really funny. Actually, maybe Beef. Squeaks does RP. Yeah. Number one, day one. Everybody make sure that you vote for your best RP streamer. Everybody keeps telling me that everybody's good at RP, but everybody knows who the streamer award should go to. Day one. All right. I would also love to win this, but that's not going to happen. We all know it. There's just too... It's too small fish, big pond. Squeaks only had like 50 GTA hours in 2023. Really? Yeah, that's true. There are a lot of people that, you know what would, I feel because there's a lot of people that do GTA RP all the time. And then like there's been this big wave of it at the end of the year. And for somebody to come in that's basically like a seasonal RP player to win would kind of suck. That would kind of suck. That guy that we played with the other night, Giant Panda, he's on there a ton. He's on there a fuck ton. Also, the person that plays Ethel is like an RP person. They do RP like regularly. Moon, yeah, is another good one. Elysium for Benji would be big. True. Who's the person that played the guy that stabbed me? Surely he does RP more often. Who's that person? That guy GP. Does he do stuff more than just recently? He rarely streams. Okay. The guy that stabbed me. Yeah, Elysium would be good. Doesn't Ray see RP 20 hours a day? I never watched Moon. Yeah, Moon does play a lot. I used to watch a lot of Moon, like back when 3.0 was big. As Fan Wake, they're good. I think, yeah, Iron Mouse was on there. I think I'm going to go with Beef. Beef is really good. And like his character is like so... such a realistic character. Like, there's a lot of really great RPers, but I think Beef is like one that just was like too good. Yeah. I also went into his stream the other day. This is beside the point, but I went to his stream the other day and he was saying some like really based stuff about women's rights, which is totally beside the fact of like RP. But like, I was just lurking and was just like kind of going on a rant about like shit that a lot of times women don't even bother explaining to men because it's just too much work. As Wake, not as Beef. So that's beside the point, but I just wanted to say it. Best Minecraft streamer. Most enjoyable streamer to watch for Minecraft. Yeah. Guys, I'm pretty sure that Minecraft is my number one most streamed category. Just saying. For best Minecraft streamer, everybody's been saying this. Guys, I'm running for best Minecraft streamer. I'm the best. Everybody agrees. Day one in the Nether, everyone knows it. I've watched Iron Mouse quite a bit do Minecraft. Iron Mouse has grown on me a lot. I used to not really get it, but then I started watching her do like Minecraft streams and like she's really funny and her voice is really fun to listen to. So I'm definitely like an Iron Mouse stan. So funny, yeah. Let's see. Who does Minecraft, though? Who do we know that does Minecraft a lot? I don't really watch too many Minecrafters. It's mostly just, like, streamers that are variety streamers that have dabbled. I kind of want to put Iron Mouse here, but... You know who I'm going to put for my favorite Minecrafter? I saw this one guy do 100%. Brody would be so mad if I put him for Minecraft streamer because there's no fucking way he wants to be nominated for anything. He would hate it if I put... Can everybody do this just because he would fucking hate it? He'd be so mad. He'd be like, so we should all do it? Yeah. Nobody likes attention making things about him than Brody, so he would be very upset about it. He would not be happy. Best IRL streamer. Streamer that creates the best IRL content, such as vlogging, traveling, and visiting places. I mean, Emily's pretty fucking good. Datune. I would put Jordan, but most of the IRL content that he does is the Paranormal Detour, and there's some categories that, like, Paranormal Detour is going to get my vote so hard. I'm trying to not use people's names multiple times. I'm trying not to. Jenny's really good too. Jenny's really, really good, but I don't really watch her that much. I have watched Emily's stuff. Do I think some of her IRL streams are a little bit on the edge of, like, I think you might get arrested for that? Yes. Sandwich took me to Eggs Benny. I would love to IRL stream enough to be qualified for this, but I don't. I mean, I have. You can vote me for this. I would be more than happy if you guys voted me for this. I would love it. Getting nominated for this would be fucking cool. I think if I got nominated for this, people would get pissed because I don't IRL stream enough to have any foot in that. I'll put Emily. It takes a lot of effort to IRL stream, and she does some pretty crazy stuff regularly. Yeah, you do need a certain percent. I think it's 100 hours in that category, which I would bet I've streamed 100 hours in IRL. They don't have an IRL category anymore. People just use just chatting. Stream game of the year. The best game to watch on stream during the past year because it was very entertaining, novel, fun to watch, interesting. Yeah, Lethal Company is actually a great one. Because there's a lot of... Oh, Only Up's a great one, too. It's between Only Up and Lethal Company for me. I think that Lethal Company's got more legs on it. And I think that the guy that did Only Up, like, stole a bunch of assets. So I'll go Lethal Company. Yeah. Best shared channel. Because two or more is better than one. This award goes to... Oh, I was watching somebody else vote for this. Baldur's Gate 3 is a great game. I think that it's mind-numbingly boring to watch. My personal opinion. I think it's a fantastic game. Lethal Company is really fun to watch. Best shared channel. I saw somebody else vote earlier for this and said a name that I didn't think of, but is probably my best pick, which is Nurse Huckleberry. Yeah. That's a great one. They have one of the coolest streams. It's like produced, looks like everything's made ahead of time, but it's not. Yeah, NMP will probably win, but this is a great choice. It's, again, if you get somebody nominated, that's pretty fucking cool, you know? Best content organization. Esports or content organization that has created the best. I popped in when Bobby was streaming this, and this was the one he was on when I popped in. And this one, so I got to think about a couple of these from here down. This one I kind of, there's a bunch of different ones. Neat Dude is one that I was thinking. Off-brand, I think, goes into this, and I do have to say from the inside out that I don't think I've been a part of any things that have run better than off-brand. Everything that I've ever done with off-brand has been phenomenally run. Like, it's it's very hard to participate in content creator organized events because content creators are so messy and disorganized, but off-brand stuff has always been smooth. There's always been 6 different people you can ask questions to. Yeah, they do. They feel like it's a business, which it is a business, but it feels like a functioning company. It's an off-brand, a production org. That's the thing, is I don't know if they fall into the category, but I don't know how they don't. Yeah. Led said they do today. Oh, okay. That's who I'm going to go with. I will say, though, that Neat Dude is another really great option that obviously I'm a part of. So, but I just have been really, really impressed by off-brand. Best streamed series. This is the only one that I'll tell you that if you don't vote for this one, I think you might just be misinformed. Because all of these are like, oh, there's a bunch of good options. I bet there's a bunch of good options for this one. Nothing compares. Nothing compares. There is nothing on the platform like Paranormal Detour. There's not even anything remotely close. Name Your Price is another good one. Critical Role, another good one. But this takes the cake for me. Easy. You should, at the least, you should check out Paranormal Detour. It is run by my friend Jordan, and he goes out with a bunch of different gear, and he does IRL ghost hunting. So he takes a couple creators into a haunted place. You know, he finds one online. They're usually places that are known to be haunted places. And he goes in, he has a IRL backpack, he's got multiple mics, different cameras, different tools, different things. And I did it once. I'm going to do it again at some point. Me and him keep trying to coordinate and it isn't working. But nobody does anything like that. Nobody does anything like that. So you should check it out. It's awesome. It is an awesome piece of content. Yeah, and that's where my sub alert comes from. Best streamed event, the most entertaining, interesting, or enjoyable single event streamed. I'm thinking that it's probably gonna get like buried, but the funeral, Point Crow's funeral, was really fucking funny. And I don't mean that because I was in it, because I wasn't really super happy with my piece of it, but it was really funny. Dodgeball was really good. My options would be Dodgeball, Point Crow Funeral, Shuffle Mania. What else? I think Shuffle Mania will get nominated. I think it'll get nominated. Yeah, the funeral. Wild West will probably get nominated. I think I put Name Your Prize for this one. Oh, the gala is a great one. That's a great one. I think Shuffle Mania will win. I'm going to put Point Crow Funeral because, again, it was produced really well. Just from, like, how difficult it is to produce live content. Like, it was really funny. It was really fucking funny. It was a great event. Yeah. Yeah, I bet the gala will probably... Most things that Cutie, like, is the head of, she probably will take out. I don't know. The gala, maybe she won't because it was a charity event. So it winning might boost the charity again, but who knows. I think recency bias will play into this one heavy. Oh, totally. They always do, yeah. That's like with the GTA RP category. Like, this is probably the worst time to be voting for that category specifically because of the big update. You're going to get a bunch of streamers that'll get nominated that don't do GTA RP. They're just on it because it's hot right now and they'll drop it in a couple weeks. Which that's how it goes. It sucks because there's people that do it all year round that are great at it, but that's just how it goes. Best international streamer. Top streamer excelling in content creation for a global audience, specifically catering to an international or non-North American English-speaking audience. Okay, non-English-speaking is kind of the big one here. Philanthropic event category. Oh, interesting. I didn't think of that. Well, I don't know, because I don't watch non-English-speaking. I think Ginny does kind of bilingual. Spectator is Canadian. Voted Brody because I can't understand him. That's fair. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Canada is North American. Didn't want to put something I didn't know. Yeah. Brody counts. For variety, I don't think I voted for variety yet. Yeah, I don't know. XQC. I don't know what the fuck he's saying. Chase, thank you for the 3. Appreciate it. Vote Sea Dog, but I have bias. Yeah, that's true. Do you think when it says to an international or non-North American English-speaking audience, that means they can be English-speaking? Because I don't know if this means they need to be non-English-speaking. Or if it's or. They can be English-speaking? Okay. Does Carlos speak Spanish on his stream? Has he spoke Spanish one time? Can anybody vouch for hearing Carlos speak Spanish on his stream one time? Yes? Okay, great. Perfect. And I'm pretty sure he's in El Salvador right now, and he's wanting to do IRL streams. So, perfect. I didn't know he's new Spanish. Yep. Best breakthrough streamer. You may not have heard of them before, but after this past year, everyone knows their name. This award goes to a streamer who has unprecedented growth and rose to streamer fame over the last year and has established themselves amongst the top streamers. Who's blown up in this last year? Oh, Caroline's a great one. Yeah, that's probably gonna... Can I vote for Caroline or no? Squeaks is another really good one. Emily, I think, kind of blew up last year. I'm gonna vote for Caroline. There are a lot of people that probably are great for this. Caroline is my personal, like, role model. She's a very good friend of mine, and I, like, love her dearly, but, like, I look up to her so much. Just as, like, a person and, like, the way she goes about life, I just admire her so much. So, plus she's banned, so, you know what I mean? Throw her a bone. Yeah, she's a great streamer. I remember, it's so funny, Eric, Will, and Caroline did Food Beast together, and it was when Caroline had first started streaming. I had never heard of her, and she came on Food Beast. She had just started streaming. She had just applied for partner, and she had been denied, so she was waiting to apply for partner again, and I met her, and we did the thing, and I was like, I immediately was like, oh, I want to be friends with her. She's so cool. And then, after that, yeah. Caroline is why I'm here. That is a beautiful sentence coming from you. The way she caught those dodgeballs. Yeah, she killed it. Yeah, that is kind of lore that I didn't expect. I don't know why. That makes sense. Meatloaf has good taste. I trust. Yeah, Caroline, easy. Easy. Best VTuber. I was gonna put Barry here, but I think I'm gonna put Barry in League of His Own because that makes too much sense. So best VTuber. I mean, I wanna vote Iron Mouse, but I don't think did Iron Mouse win last year? Can anybody confirm or deny that somebody can win multiple years in a row for the category? Oh, Jaden Animations is good. They can. Okay, got it. Yeah, Rosie's a great pick. Iron Mouse's story is just so uplifting. She gets my vote as long as she's active. Yeah, Jaden or Giwi would make sense if you choose to do something else. Yeah, I really like Giwi. I actually haven't watched Giwi's streams, but I have hung out with her like a couple times. I didn't know that she streamed actually most of the times that I hung out with her. Yeah, Rosie was my pick. I kind of want to put Rosie down just for the principle of it. Like, I love Rosalton. Rosie is, like, when I lived in Arizona, I had Rosie and Morgo because I didn't know anybody else that was in Arizona. And when I was doing Hired or Fired, my internet in Arizona was kind of unstable. So two different times I packed my computer up and drove it to Rosie's and set it up on his living room floor on a coffee table. And then me and Rosie and Morgo I would do whatever stream I had planned. And then we would go up to the rooftop and we would get drunk and the whole state was like burning down for some reason. So we would just get drunk and we would look at the smoke. And it like, I want to like, this was like, I had just moved to Arizona out of Oregon. My life was like, had been uprooted and was in a whirlwind. I had not moved to LA yet. So I was kind of in this like limbo, and Rosie and Morgo were like, they were there. Like, we all just would go to Rosie's house and we would just, I think I spent like 3 nights at Rosie's house once, 'cause I took my PC there. And then I was like, what do I have to go back to? Like, I brought my dog with me. And so I remember like, we would go to Walmart at like 2 a.m. to get like shitty cheap alcohol. Yeah, it was a sweet time. It was like just a sweet memory. So I don't know. I don't really see Rosie too much right now, but I'm just always gonna be a Rosie fan. Yeah, alcohol at Walmart. Yeah, in Arizona you can get alcohol at like a bunch of different places. Best just chatting streamer. This is like impossible because there's so many people that fall into this category. Because just chatting is kind of like the, you know what I mean? 24/7 Walmart was the shit. Yeah, they don't do that anymore. A lot of them don't. Sandwich for just chatting. Everybody's been saying this day one. Best streamer that regularly does just chatting content, such as conversing with chat, video commentary, reacting to news, sharing engaging stories, entertaining group activities. We do need to do something with Rosie again. Exactly. I sent something to Rosie Morgo and I told him to share it with you. Did he share it with you? Did he forward it to you? It was an invite to something. No. Oh, okay. Do I have your phone number? No, I don't. Chat, I hate to stop stream to do this, but I know me, and if I don't do this right now, I will forget. And I don't know if Morgo will bump me because they're too nice. Okay. There you go. I thought I had your number too, but I unless it's in there as something else. Yeah. Best just chatting streamer. I would put Caroline again, but that seems just, I don't want to repeat people. Hassan's a good choice, but I don't really watch a whole lot of Hassan, to be honest. Yeah, Will's a good one. Will's a good one. Will told people to not to nominate him because he doesn't want to lose again. That's awesome. A lot of Charles White. I don't know who that is. Prezzo. Is Will just chatting, though? That's the thing, is I don't know if he is. I don't think he does technically fall into that category, but I've seen him doing stuff more than just chatting. Is Charles White? Oh, I don't think I ever knew his last name. I knew it was Charlie, but sandwich is pretty good. You guys can vote for me. I'm not gonna win this or get nominated for this, but for this and Sapphire Award, this might be my only double. Yeah. She's banned. You know, throw her a bone. Best variety streamer. Best streamer that broadcasts variety content across multiple categories. This is another one that it's like there's 37,000 fucking people that could be in here. I mean, Will could be this one. Yeah, Eric could be this one. Yeah, Will might be a good one for here because Daff is a really good one, yeah. Yeah, Caitlin, same. Oh, Jerma's good. How much has Jerma streamed this year, though? I put Spooky for this. Fair. I'm such a big Jerma fan, but I put Connor Eats Pants. Connor is actually, like, probably one of the most variety streamers of anybody. There is no limit to the kind of games that Connor will try on stream. Like, he will play anything. He'll play everything. He has no niche. Jerma won the first League of Their Own. No. Well, the first one. Cassio. That person is an anomaly to me because I've never heard of them. I've never heard of anybody talk about them. I've never seen them associate with anybody, but they rock like 50,000 viewers. And I don't get it. Did they just blow up? Have they always been around and I just didn't know? Is it Cassio? I don't know how to say their username. This guy pulls like 50,000 viewers. He's a TikTok guy. He's funny. He has funny clips. But did he pop off recently? Is it a recent pop off? He blew up on TikTok, but more than I've ever seen anybody blow up on TikTok. But the thing is that's interesting is I never hear anybody talk about him. I never hear other streamers talk about him. I never hear anybody collab with him. And so he's just like an anomaly, kind of. It's very weird. Like, I've never heard his name. I just know he polls like 50,000 people. It's very weird. He has 66K right now. Yeah, is he streaming right now? And he streams like single player, like he was doing Outlast. He was doing, let's see. Yeah. This guy.
Do we send Ted with checkers? That's something we didn't know about.
Look at his chat, dude. Having a chat this big and not having slow mode on is unhinged. Just like stock cam.
H1Z1 was a good game. Dude, H1Z1 was a good game back in the day.
But he has like a crazy TikTok. Like he pulls. It's like one of those weird, just like, I don't get it, I don't understand. Yeah, his TikTok is crazy. It pulls like millions of views. Every single TikTok has millions of views. 3 million, 2 million, 2 million, 2 million, 2 million, 2 million, 1 million, 2 million, 1 million, 2 million, 3 million, 1 million, 2 million. And they're just like gaming TikToks. They're, a lot of them are funny. It's not like a weird, like, what's going on here. They are funny, but it's just, it's, and then his Twitch tracker, let me show you. Does he have like an underscore or something? Oh yeah, it's an underscore. Yeah, these are his stats. So July of 2020, let's see. He was averaging, so September 2022, about 600 viewers. He's averaged like a pretty good amount, under 1K, but you know, definitely not small. But then like middle of last year, 5K, 15K, 18K, 26K, 31K, 54K. Just like blew the fuck up. Just absolutely monopolizing the algorithm. Has tapped into the algorithm. Doing, and no offense to him, not really anything like innovative. It just happened to work. And his TikToks are, you know, they're funny. So yeah, it's interesting. I've kind of become fascinated with it recently. Like, I don't, like, I'm just like, I think I'm more fascinated with it just because I'm not hearing anybody talk about him, but clearly people are watching. His chat moves so fucking fast. Because his chat to make fun of him, and it's really funny. He also like doesn't I've never seen him collab with people, and for the size of the streamer he is, he still interacts with them a decent amount, you know. Literally found out the YouTube algo and his Twitch tracker shoots from 100 to 10k in like a week. Yeah, I've heard his name like a lot recently, and I don't know what does he do. Yeah, I think he started streaming in 2022, but it just started. I don't know if Pirate Software Guy, they also broke tons of Hype Train stuff. Like, heard briefly, but haven't looked into. It's like a game dev hacker, I think. Huh. He did a collab with Kai and Jinxie a few days ago. So I mean, I guess technically he would go here, but I haven't really watched so much of his stuff, and I don't know. I think Kai won an award last year, but just wasn't there for it. They had like a cardboard cutout. Best variety streamer. I kind of want to put Will here. Will's a pretty solid variety streamer. Also, Connor is a really great, like, Connor streams everything. Like, he kind of is the definition of a variety streamer. Making software for 18 years. Ooh. Random games, yeah. I put Connor. Yeah, I'll put Connor. Because, yeah, he definitely does mega variety. The Sapphire Award. I think this is a good category. This year, this is the thing we were talking about the other day, where we were like, I don't know how you do this, but it's a good one. I think they did this about the best that you could have. This award recognizes a streamer who, like a sapphire, is formed against all odds. This streamer has excelled in entertaining at the highest level this past year, despite facing significant challenges in an industry where 97% of the top streamers are male. This award is dedicated to streamers who identify as female or a marginalized gender and flourish in the face of adversity. Yeah, I think they nailed that. It's a good one. Kitty was talking about how she put a lot of thought into it. Yeah, I think she did a really good job. It also kind of alleviates the, because like we were talking about the other day, as a woman, there's a lot of weirdness around having a female streamer award. The first reason is it's just going to get hate. Anybody that wins it is going to get hated on. Secondly, if you have a lot of, if you have a female streamer of the year award, there's no chance that a woman's going to win streamer of the year award. Like, it's just not going to happen. And then also, then you also want categories for other marginalized groups of people, but how do you start breaking them down? So I think that this is a really good way to be like, you know, female or other marginalized genders, or creators. It's just kind of like a, you know what I mean? I think they did this. I think she did this good. I think this is good. I put Maya, but she'll probably not ask to be on there. Yeah, Maya's a good one. Caroline's also a really good one. I don't want to give Caroline the 3-time. I love her, but she got the 2-time. I'm trying to think of other breakout people that I, you know what I mean? I would like to see a girl win. Mm-hmm. Ray got on Vogue this year. I also saw that she just turned 32, which I hate to do this because I get annoyed when people do this. When you go like, oh my God, you don't look that age, because then it's like, oh, well, is there something wrong with being that age? But as a female creator, I have this kind of fear of aging because I am worried that it diminishes my value, which is not true, but that's what the industry has taught us. And so I was kind of like, you know what? Fuck it. Got A for this one, but she might decline if nominated after getting hate for winning Valorant last year. Oh, true. True. Yeah, there's a lot of really great options here. Okay, well, this is a great way to choose and see if there's anybody online right now that I go, oh, obviously that person. Yeah, there are some really good ones. God, I follow so many people. Was Non live when he came in here? Shameless. I don't know if she's big enough to qualify. Oh, do they have a... I don't think they have a... You have to be this big, but... You know, at some point, you just need the votes. I don't know if I can handle following that many people. I follow that many people. I still only watch, like, the same couple people. I kind of, like, poke around. I just... Follows are free, and I like to see what's up. I think I follow that many because I like to be in the know of what's going on. I feel like I have too many names and also not enough to names. Is there any non-female, like, streamers that I'm not thinking of? Like, any names I'm, like, spacing? You know who kind of popped off? Kip popped off on YouTube, which is not streaming, that's YouTube videos, but that was really cool to see. I was really stoked about that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put Kip because the YouTube shit was really cool to see. I know that they like really wanted YouTube to work. And to see that work, it's nice to see somebody want something and then see it happen. And so I was really happy to see that. Yeah. League of Their Own. There's a lot of really great people for this category, but I would be amiss if I didn't put Barry. Because whether or not he would clutch the win, the definition of this fits very few people better. Yeah. Yeah, the only thing I would worry about would be streaming hours, but I don't think it matters. Germa's great too, but I don't know. I think Germa's doing just fine. I'm a huge Germa stan. Don't get me wrong. Gamer of the Year. Streamer who has extraordinary gaming ability and has performed exceptionally at a variety of games over the past year. No matter what game they're playing, you just have to watch. I might write Squeaks in here. There's a lot of really good ones. Yeah, Doug would be great, but like, I don't know. Squeaks is just so fucking funny. He's so good, dude. And like, he does a lot of different stuff. Yeah, he kind of like niches into like the Nintendo stuff or whatever, but he's just so entertaining. You know what I mean? Yeah. Oh, you can't see? How long have you guys not been able to see? Just, it's been like probably 10 minutes. Him trolling it with the little girl is funny. Yeah. Yeah, I think I gotta go Squeaks for this. Also, I did play beer pong with him, and he hit a really cool behind the back shot, and so I think that that counts. Streamer of the Year. The best overall streamer of the past year. They saw great success with their entertaining content, elevated their brand, and in general left their mark on viewers. I don't even fucking know. That's such a huge one. What do you guys think? Thoughts? I don't know. You guys are always talking about him. I've just been hearing his name a lot recently, so it would allude to me under the assumption that that's who the people's choice would be. Yeah, the self-promo, a little shameless. A little shameless. But what about Brody? It would be funny because he would hate it. But we already voted him for Minecraft. Again, because he would hate it. Yeah. Great. Okay, I think that that's probably going to be my pick. My personal pick, yeah. Yeah. Final scroll through? Sure. All right, starting from the top. Creative Arts, Cheese, MMO, S-Fand, Strategy Game Streamer, Non, my Dota streamer, Best Chess Streamer, Lud, Software, Doug, Fighting Game Streamer, Slime, Speedrun Streamer, Bobby Berm, Hidden Gem, Scootish, Battle Royale, Sammy, Best FPS Streamer, Slime, Rising Star, Exist, Best Role Play Streamer, Wake Wilder, Best Minecraft Streamer, Brody, Best IRL Streamer, Extra Emily, Stream Game of the Year, Lethal Company, Shared Channel, Nurse Huckleberry, Content Organization, Off Brand, Streamed Series, Paranormal Detour, Streamed Event, Point Crow Funeral, International Streamer, Carlos, Breakthrough Streamer, Caroline, VTuber, Rousey, Just Chatting, Caroline, Variety Streamer, Connor Eats Pants, Sapphire Award, Kip, League of Their Own, Barry, Gamer of the Year, Squeaks, Streamer of the Year, B. Yep, I think that that's gotta be it. Really? You know, not, I don't feel as stumped as I did for the Game Awards. When we did the Game Awards, I felt like I had no idea for most of them. But this one I feel pretty good about. I feel good about it. I can retire now. Don't. Keep it going. Yeah, that's pretty good. That is good shit. The Game Awards was a bunch of same IMO. Yeah, cool. Where's the FAQ? I should have read that. FAQ. Frequently asked questions. Probably should have read this beforehand. Frost Prime, hello. Are you on a D-Gen schedule right now? Kind of seems like you're on a D-Gen schedule because of the... Are you doing a subathon? You didn't put me on that list and I am now going to mail a surprise package to your door as consequence of your actions. Is it going to be a big brick of gluten? That's very dangerous for me. When does the choosing categories phase begin? Choosing categories starts on December 27th. Okay, we already did that. Final award categories include only the games that are voted on. Juniper, thank you for the prime and the 7 months. This one I think is for nominations. When does the nominations begin? January 8th. Can I nominate streamers that stream on Twitch, YouTube, Kick, Facebook, or non-English speaking streamers? Yes. Are there any constraints on which streamers I can nominate? For your nominated streamer to be considered for any award, they must have streamed for at least 200 hours. For your nominated streamer to be considered for a specific award, they must have streamed for at least 100 hours in that category. What criteria should I use for choosing nominations? I don't need to read all of this. We just voted. When does the nominations phase end? January 19th. So... just so you know. Day 6 tomorrow? Huge. This is gigantic for Frost Prime enjoyers. Yeah, that was fun. It was good. That's always a fun time. It's always really fun to like, I know people get really... people get all weird about streamer awards because they say it's like a circle jerk thing. And like, I'll say this, like, it sometimes seems like that because the person who hosts it has shared audiences with a lot of the people who are like the largest streamers on the platform. So it's kind of inevitable. It's kind of unavoidable that it's gonna seem like that. At the end of the day, I get to wear a cunty little sparkly dress and go drink overpriced drinks and get excited for my friends. So I'm gonna have a great time. It's nice to see these award events each year. Plus, we will have the Chatter Awards in February, which is really fun. But for you, Queen, stop it. Thank you. Yeah, Dan Clancy's a streamer. We should have put Dan Clancy on there. What can you ask for? Exactly. We all deserve a cunty dress and overpriced drinks at least once as a treat. Isn't the point of an award ceremony to be a little self-masturbatory? You know what? Exactly. Exactly. It's great. So I have an excuse to come to LA and see friends. True. Very true. I think that for a lot of people it is an excuse, nomination or not, to take a trip to LA, which is cool. I mean, I know people that are coming to watch it that are that I'm excited to see. I think Bobby was talking about going to the Streamer Awards. I don't know if he's going to or not, but you know, that's cool. Definitely gonna watch everything this year. Yeah, it'll be fun. I'm excited. I'm excited. It's a fun event. Very fun stuff. I think I want to do like an IRL stream, going and go dress shopping. I don't know if I'll buy a dress because it's hard to really focus when you IRL stream, and for dress shopping, I kind of feel like I need to focus. So I hope I'm able to go to the Streamer Awards. Yeah. Do it. Who hosted the Golden Globes? I don't know. Do they have a host, a different host every year? Is cunty different from sexy? Cunty is like very girl boss and slay and like You did that. She did that. It's good. Cunty is bitchy in a good way. Yeah, it's like, it's very, Cunty is being sexy, but just for yourself. Yeah, it's just like a confidence thing, you know? It's like if somebody's dressed cunty, then it's like they're, you know, I don't know. Yeah, like, yeah. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. Fuck you, I wear what I want. Yeah, exactly. How bad they were. Those boots were made for walking. Oh, the host. Yeah, I don't know who the host was. Yeah, I don't know. I have no idea. It's serving. Julia Fox is cunty. I feel like Meryl Streep is kind of cunty. But like in the good way, you know?
Welcome to the 81st Annual Golden Globes. I'm 81st? Your host, Joe Coy.
Oh, well, that's why.
Look, I'm just taking this all in. Let me look around. I'm taking this all in. I'm so excited to be here. This is a dream come true, not just for me, but for everybody in here. We all dreamt of this moment. And look at this. Look at this room. Look around. I mean, like look around. Look, Kevin Costner's here. Kevin Costner's here.
Kevin Costner looks like
Kevin
he doesn't
Costner's
want to be there.
Never here. Kevin's like in a mountain with a cow or something, but today he's here. Don Cheadle's here. I'm just looking around. Just everybody's here.
This is a Globes clip. Oh, fuck, I probably shouldn't watch this, huh? Fuck. Yeah, I'm not going to watch it. Was it just cringe? Did he just make cringe jokes? I had a friend once who was loved him, said he was like the best comedian ever, and she also slept with like two of my friends' boyfriends. So that is all I have to associate with Joe Coy. No funny jokes and then blames the writers. Oh, cringe jokes and made some off-putting jokes about a few things. They panned to Taylor Swift after his joke about her and she just sipped on her drink unamused. Oh my gosh. Can you watch the clips? You can't just watch restream the live. I don't know. And I'm not quite sure like what Caroline did, but she said that she didn't watch it live. So I don't know. I do not know. Not worth the risk. Caroline watched that specific video. Good. Good. Hey, Fa! I'm joining you in prison! Let's go! I need a couple days off. What are you doing? Well, just like, it'll be like passing in the hallway. Like, she'll be on her way back to class, and I'll be on my way to the bathroom, and we'll just like. And then she'll just like keep going. My turn! Let's go! Ruth and Fa IRL. Truly. Truly. I've never been banned before. Fuck it. Ruth and Foo in prison would be great. Yeah. Me and Caroline are not metagaming, but we're definitely like, we've been texting a lot and being like, this is so fun. Like, our characters are so fun. Like talking about what would be fun plot lines, you know? May as well get the first ban out of the way. Might as well. There's always got to be a first. It's funny when you think about it, like this is our job, right? Like, So we want to make a YouTube video of like the other day when me and Caroline and Will and Giant Panda were like on that whole whatever, and we're having like a great funny time. The problem is that Morty can't pull Caroline's point of view because she's banned. And when you get banned, your whole account just disappears. But it also disappears on your end too. So you can't check your dashboard. You can't check anything, which I think should be illegal because you get your tax forms from your dashboard. You get your everything having to do with your finances from your dashboard. There's like a bunch of shit that you get on your dashboard. And when you're banned, you can't access any of it. So if you needed to pull a tax form in your 3-day ban, you can't. You can't have it. There might be another way to get it, but I don't know how. You still get paid out if you're banned. As long as you're not banned during too close to the payout period. I have heard of people that their payout gets put onto the next payout because they get banned. So if you're banned, you don't have to pay taxes. Well, you do, because I mean, it depends. That'd be kind of interesting if you got banned indefinitely. They'd probably have to give you your tax forms. Because, like, if I got banned indefinitely, I'd need to access my tax forms for last year. Yeah, if you get permabanned, I'm sure that they would probably let you have access to some shit. Yeah. But it does suck. Because, yeah, like, Caroline, she was like, if I could have access to my dashboard, I would make YouTube videos. She was like, I have to sit here and I can't do anything. She's like, I can't make videos. I can't work on clips. I can't access anything. I just have to sit here on my hands. So it's weird. Like, imagine any other job where they were like, hey, you know, you work at McDonald's. Hey, you did this wrong. Leave, don't come back for 3 days, but you're not even allowed to be on the premises. Like, if you had to get banned for 3 days and not be on the premises of McDonald's, they would fire you. You wouldn't get banned for 3 days and not be able to come on the premises. Like, they would just fire you. So it's just weird. It's like a weird work thing to get banned on your, you know what I mean? Work suspension, yeah. Which, like, work suspensions are weird. Like, what could you possibly do that your job would suspend you? I mean, if you're a cop, I think a cop is, like, the only job I know that you can do something wrong and they suspend you but don't fire you. Which is, like, huh? You know? She watched a clip from something that you can watch in full for free on their website, yeah. It kind of sucks, too, because a 3-day ban is short enough that, like, by the time they figure out that maybe it was okay, she's already unbanned. Suspension is more, could be a thing where they have to do a retraining course, which is kind of funny because it's like, if Twitch is going to ban you, they might as well retrain you. You know what I mean? Like, if they're going to ban you for 3 days, maybe send you an email that, like, they tell you a lot of times what you did, but not in detail, and you don't get to talk to a person, you just get an email. So it's like, I don't know, it's weird. I've suspended people while doing investigations, which oftentimes leads to them being fired anyways, right? What do you, you don't have to say what you do, but I'm curious. If you fuck something up and they need to get you out of the lab to investigate and fix it, yeah. Wrong for what? I'm not telling you. Okay. But even when you're fired, your employer has to mail you your W-2 and shit still. Yeah, it just is like, I don't understand why it's impossible for Twitch to make a system where if you get banned, your stream key becomes inactive. And you can't type in chats. But you can still access your dashboard. You can still see all of your information. You can still do your job off of the platform. You know what I mean? Like, if you got suspended from your job, like Jess was saying, like, say Jess was like, hey, we have to do an investigation, go home. She probably doesn't say, go out right now, leave. She probably says, if you need to grab anything from your office, you know what I mean? Like, please do grab anything that you need. And that's what Twitch should do, is like, hey, you can't be here, but if you need anything from the website, you can get it. Mine would be all freeze, no access. I guess it depends if you have like an online job though. Jeff Bezos, not a famously chill boss, but famously really bald. More bald than other people, somehow. Okay. So, we are watching Saltburn in the Discord tonight, which is a wild one, but I've been told that it's good. I've also been told it's a little bit wacky. I'm looking up the trigger warnings. I know, trigger warning, you'd see a penis. Yeah, it's rated R. I'm trying to find the specific ones. I'm just gonna copy and paste this. This is like the parental guide. It says, sex and nudity. It looks like there's potential, I don't know. There's one scene that is just wild. Yeah. Violence and gore, profanity, alcohol, drugs, and smoking, frightening and intense scenes. Eating disorders, I'm seeing in there. I'm trying not to like spoil myself, but it looks like pretty graphically sexual. Just a lot. What doesn't it have? Yeah, I would just, it sounds like just, you know what I mean? Like glazing over it. But I would say if you have any triggers that are really bad, I would maybe just skip it. I don't really know what kind of things are in here, but I know it's pretty like shocking. So everything did one for Saltburn and it was really good. Oh, really? Isn't she great? I always stumble on her videos and I go, oh, she's so great. And then I forget about her. And then YouTube will give me another one and I'll be like, oh, I forgot how great she is. Too much for me to handle, but it sounds like a really well-made movie. Yeah. Yeah. Nicole Raffi. Yeah, she's great. Really good. Cool. It's not that wild if you've seen art films that are shocking for the sake of it. Yeah, I was talking to, because Brody watched it in their Discord for movie night, and he said it was really good. He said he enjoyed it a lot. He said he went into it from the mentality of, like, not having any expectations, and he said that he did like it. But what else did he say? We were talking about movies that have graphic scenes just for the sake of having graphic scenes, and they can like irk me sometimes because there's a lot of movies that like I feel like the plot is not super strong, so they just throw graphic scenes in to like spice it up. A lot of horror movies do this. A lot of horror movies will have really intense or awful sex scenes, you know, a lot of like horrifying sex scenes, a lot of like things like that that are just like shocking. And I go away from it being like, I don't know anything about that movie. I feel like I just got jump scared by needing to not watch the movie. Kingsman church scene, that's such a good scene. It's like just on the line of like not being able to show it on stream, and I think that they drop some slurs, but And pointless to the rest of the movie. Yeah, there's just a level where sometimes I think the directors are just like getting off on making people watch fucked up shit. Like, what was that one show with The Weeknd in it that everybody was like, okay, this is not a good show and everything about it is disturbing? Thing I found in the movie night chat. All right, sick. I wish you could pin, I know you can pin things in Discord, but I wish you could pin them in the same way that they're on Twitch chat. So like, if you pinned it, it was always like right at the top, like as a thing, the way that it's in Twitch chat, because there's, unless you know that there's a pin for that chat, the pins are kind of pointless. Like, you have to know that there's an important pin. Do we have time to get snacks? Yeah, I'm gonna raid right now. I have a lot of stuff I have to do tonight. Because I want to clean my house. And then tomorrow, I'm going to try to stream in the morning. Tomorrow night is going to be my big, like, packing, getting ready night. So I'm not going to stream tomorrow night because I want to get everything fully ready. And then I'm going to leave later in the week. I'm not saying what day. But, so I'm going to get a bunch of shit done tonight, stream tomorrow morning, get a bunch of shit done tomorrow night, and then we'll see where we get. Where are you going? To the moon! To the moon! Cool. So let's go raid somebody, and then it's 10 o'clock right now, Pacific time. And it's 10 o'clock Pacific time. Let's do the movie at let's do it at like 10:20. We usually do 10 to 15 minutes after I raid out, but let's do like 10:20. That'll be good. That'll be good shit. Okay, let's go raid. Ooh, let's raid Billy. We don't get to raid Billy like ever. Where is she? She's playing Amanda the Adventurer, which is a game that we've played before. The raid message is gonna be, mind if we raid in? There we go. That's gonna be the raid message. Okay. About 20 minutes in the Discord. We're watching Saltburn. Keep in mind, it's a little, you know, it's a little heavy, but it's apparently good. Go say hi to Billy. She's cool. And then I'm gonna stream in the morning. I think I wanna go try to do Eggs Benny or something. I don't know. Just, I don't know what I'm gonna stream in the morning. I might stream here. I might stream Eggs Benny. I might do IRL. I don't know. I don't really have any plans. So, yeah, there's gonna be a stream in the morning. So I will see you guys then. Thank you for hanging out. I appreciate it. Thank you for participating in the voting, if you did. And I will see you guys soon. And have a good night. And I will see you guys shortly in the Discord. Thanks for hanging out. I appreciate it. Go say hi to Billy. She's cool. Don't spoil it. We played this game. Don't spoil anything. It's a fun game. Bye.